Hey guys, welcome back to Best Movies Recap. Today we are back with the final chapter of the legendary franchise, Pirates of the Caribbean. Without any further delay, let's get started. The movie begins with Henry Turner leaving his home in the dark of night to take a rowboat out to the middle of the ocean. He then used a makeshift anchor to take himself to the bottom of the sea and inside the Flying Dutchman. The ship then bursts out of the water, with Will approaching Henry. William admonishes his son's decision as Henry tries to convince him that his curse can be broken by the Trident of Poseidon, but William begs him to stop believing because the Trident can never be found. Henry insists, saying that he already finds the Flying Dutchman, and with the help of Captain Jack Sparrow, he will find the Trident. But William tells his son to stay away from the pirates and the sea. He then gives his son his necklace, as he tells him to give up on him and send him back up to his boat. 9 years later, Henry is a sailor aboard the Monarch, a British naval vessel that is chasing a Dutch ship that was stolen by pirates. Henry notices that they are going into the Devil's Triangle and tries to warn the captain, but he is arrested right before they enter the Devil's Triangle. They are soon attacked by the undead pirates of the Silent Mary. The ghost pirates slay the soldiers one by one. Boarding the warship is Captain Armando Salazar, who makes his way down to the brig and sees a wanted poster for Jack Sparrow. He then orders Henry to deliver a message to Jack that Salazar and death are coming for him soon or later. On the island of Saint Martin, a young woman named Karina Smith is locked up in a cell after being accused of witchcraft. In reality, she is just very knowledgeable in astronomy and horology. While speaking to a priest, she manages to pick her lock and escape. Meanwhile, Jack has broken into a bank vault and is found sleeping in it. His crew hooks up the whole bank to a bunch of horses and has them pull it through the streets. They make it back to Jack's new ship, which is strapped to a small shack by the shore. When the crew brings the vault onto the ship, they find the whole thing empty, except for a single coin which Jack nabs for himself. The crew has become frustrated with how Jack has been leading them. Even Gibbs has lost faith in him, so they all turn their backs on him and leave him alone. On the other side, Henry finds himself waking up while being shackled to a bed due to the removal of his coat sleeves, which is a sign of treason left on him by Captain Toms. He is soon approached by Karina, who wants to help him find the Trident of Poseidon with a diary she has in her possession that has a map to the Trident, and this map only came into view during a blood moon, with the help of a red jewel that she has been carrying. They are both then chased by the British soldiers. The two try to escape. But Karina is soon captured and then taken back to prison. During a blood moon, Karina uses the light to uncover a secret clue that will lead her to the Trident of Poseidon. Meanwhile, Jack, who already lost his crew and he is broke and disheveled, decides to trade his compass for a bottle of rum, noticing that the compass began to shake and rattle, but unaware that this was the key to setting Salazar and his crew free from the Devil's Triangle, allowing them to roam the seas and seek out Jack. After that, Jack is captured, but long before being sent for execution, he meets Henry Turner, who feels disappointed when he sees Jack as a disgraced drunk locked up in a cell. He tells Jack how he plans to break his father's curse and coerce Jack into helping him by mentioning that the undead Armando Salazar is hunting him down. The next morning, Jack and Karina are brought to the gallows for their execution. Before Jack and Karina's sentences are carried out, Henry rounds up Jack's crew to help him free Sparrow, even though it's only because Henry is paying them to save Jack. The pirates fight the guards and the executioner, with Karina nearly getting hung until Henry catches her. Everyone makes their way to the dying gull, and they manage to release it from its holdings. Somewhere else across the ocean, Captain Hector Barbosa is enjoying his time as the captain of the Queen Anne's Revenge, after taking it from the Blackbeard, with his new crew helping him reap many rewards. However, Barbosa is informed by Mulroy and Murdoch that several ships had been attacked by the Silent Mary. Because of this, Barbosa seeks out the witch Shansa. She tells Barbosa that the dead men have already taken control of the sea, and they are looking for Jack. She advises him to leave his pirate life behind, or he will die. But he refuses and asks her for another option. She then gives him Jack Sparrow's compass, and tell him to make a deal with Salazar. With this, Barbosa's crew locates Salazar, But as the Silent Mary approaches the Queen Anne's revenge ship with the intent to destroy it, Barbossa prevents this by calling out to Salazar and mentioning Jack's name. Salazar boards the ship and has his men kill the crew until he gets Jack's location, but Barbossa doesn't know his exact location. However, he manages to prevent himself from being killed by promising to find Jack by the next sunrise. As Barbossa traveled with Salazar to find Jack, Salazar begins to tell his tale of how Jack took his life away. Salazar was a powerful captain in the Spanish Navy. His goal was to clean the seas with his men from all pirates. One day while chasing a ship of pirates, he came across the young Jack, still just a crew member aboard a ship. As Salazar and his crew laid waste to Jack's crew, Jack gets his famous compass from the dying captain, who tells him how to use it, and with his quick thinking, Jack tricked Salazar into sailing his ship into the Devil's Triangle. Salazar's ship and his men were destroyed, but the power of the Devil's Triangle cursed them, which turns them all into dead men. Jack, who saves the pirates, became captain of the ship. And now Salazar wants to find Jack to take his revenge and kill every last pirate out there. Once Salazar finished telling his tale to Barbossa, he prepares to kill him, but Barbossa notices the dying gull sailing up ahead and tells Salazar. At this moment, Jack's crew discovered that Jack is being hunted by dead sailors for the sole purpose of revenge. They immediately aim their guns at Jack in frustration, and Jack then decides to call upon mutiny, having Henry and Karina join him on a rowboat. It wasn't long until the Silent Mary managed to catch up with Jack, Henry, and Karina. She hops off the rowboat and swims to the nearby island. Before Henry can go ahead and do the same, Salazar has reanimated dead sharks and sends them after Jack and his crew. Jack and Henry try to evade the sharks, and they manage to hook onto one and use it to ride their boat to the shore. Salazar and his men run after them, but they are unable to touch land without burning up in the sun. Salazar vows to wait for Jack as he and Henry head to the island. As Karina runs off, she gets trapped in a net just as Jack and Henry travel the jungle and find her. Before they could free her, they are trapped as well. Then three men arrive and recognize Jack before knocking him out. Meanwhile, Barbossa and his crew are hung upside down by the angry Salazar, but Barbossa prevents the death of himself and a few men by promising to bring back Jack, since he can't escape the island. Salazar accepts this and frees Barbossa, who goes off to the island. After that, Jack awakes to find Henry and Karina tied up, as well as a rope tied around his neck. It turns out that the island is called Hangman's Bay, and it is the base of a pirate named Pig Kelly, who Jack owes a large debt as repayment. He forces him to take part in a wedding with his sister Beatrice, whom Jack does not want to marry, though he accidentally says, "I accept," after his allies try to help him. Before the marriage can proceed, it is interrupted and stopped by the arrival of Barbossa and his crew with a gunshot. Barbossa dispatches Kelly, causing his crew to run off, freeing Jack and his crew from the wedding. Barbossa then announces his intent to find the Trident of Poseidon to claim vengeance on Salazar. After Jack questions this plan because there is no ship capable of escaping Salazar, Barbossa is aware that the Black Pearl is with Jack, and it only needs to be restored to its original size. With the Sword of Triton, Barbossa stabs through the ship bottle of the Black Pearl. The crew then hurried to get the Black Pearl onto the water. Although Jack notices the Black Pearl beginning to grow larger than before, its size wasn't quite large enough. Barbossa soon threw the ship into the water as it properly returns to its original size. As Jack looks upon the Black Pearl finally restored, his joy is short-lived once Barbossa immediately assumes captaincy by holding Sparrow and his company at gunpoint. On the way to the Trident, Barbossa has Jack tied to the mast. He goes to talk to Karina as she looks up at the stars. Barbossa suggests that Karina's father was a thief, and she slaps him in response. She tells Barbossa how she was named after a star. After seeing the design in her diary, Barbossa figures her name is Karina. He goes back to Jack, and they both realize that Karina is Barbossa's daughter. He explains to Jack that he gave up a child for adoption a long time ago, and figures this must be her. Barbossa doesn't want anyone else to know, and he threatens to cut out Jack's tongue if he breathes a word. As the Black Pearl sets off to search for the Trident of Poseidon under Karina's command, Captain Scarfield spots the Black Pearl, to which he orders his crew to begin an attack. However, before they could even begin an attack, the Silent Mary makes an unexpected visit and crushes the ship into pieces, with gunpowder burning the ship in flames. The Silent Mary then joins the Black Pearl in a fierce battle, having the crewmen of both ships battle against each other and Salazar chasing Jack. Karina then notices that both ships are beginning to approach an island of their destination. Realizing they are in danger of vanishing, the Spanish retreat back to the Silent Mary, while the ship makes a sharp starboard turn to avoid hitting the shore. Salazar attempts to finish off Jack, but upon seeing the island runs to the helm in an attempt to change the ship's course. However, the Black Pearl hits the shore, forcing Salazar to jump back to his ship, taking Henry with him. Barbossa, Jack, and Karina approached Black Rock Island as their final destination in searching for the Trident of Poseidon, which is where the map that no men can read led to. Having found the island, they spotted a giant red jewel where the last piece would be restored, opening an underwater entrance to Poseidon's tomb, where the Trident would be located. Meanwhile, Salazar discussed with his crew how they would plan to approach Jack and his party, with the captured Henry being tied in a mast. Salazar decided that he would approach Jack by inputting himself into Henry's body. Jack and Karina accidentally fall into the underwater entrance, discovering the exact location of the Trident. Jack, fully unaware of what happened to Henry, finds himself in a fierce duel with an enraged Henry controlled by Salazar. Karina attempts to reach to the Trident, but is stopped by Salazar as he takes the Trident away from her and begins to remove himself from Henry's body. Karina quickly tries to wake Henry up after he falls to the floor. After being released from Henry's body, Salazar began to throw Sparrow through the water, where Lieutenant Lessero and the rest of the crew attempted to grab him and drown him. As this happens, Henry wakes up with him and Karina, recalling the legend that if one were to destroy the Trident, all curses would be broken. After toying with Sparrow, Salazar is annoyed by Jack's taunt, which he used before he defeated Salazar years ago, and stabbed Jack in the chest with the Trident, shushing him as he attempted to push the Trident more into his body. Jack, now realizing the Trident stabbed a book held in his jacket, urged Henry to help. Henry grabbed his sword and sent it crashing down on the Trident, breaking it in half and breaking all the curses of the sea. After destroying the Trident of Poseidon, Salazar and his crew are returned to their mortal forms, with their curse finally broken. However, without the power of the Trident, the walls of the ocean slowly started to fill in the area, threatening to drown everyone. Jack, Henry, and Karina grab onto the anchor line from the Black Pearl, with Barbossa attempting to lend a hand. As they run, Salazar pursues them while his crew runs to the anchor to save themselves. As they climb the anchor, Karina begins to fall further down, but is quickly saved by Barbossa, who reveals a tattoo on his arm of the stars, and Karina soon realizes what it means. She asks him what she is to him. Barbossa responds, "My treasure." Noticing that Salazar was right behind Karina, Barbossa then has Karina hold onto the anchor as Jack gives Barbossa Henry's sword. Grasping the blade, he makes a sacrifice to save his daughter by letting himself fall and stabbing Salazar with his sword at the same time. A defeated Salazar falls, hitting the anchor face first before being washed away by the consuming sea with some of his crew. Barbossa falls not long after while gazing at his daughter and allies as the walls of the sea close after him. The trio return to the Pearl still shocked after witnessing the moment of the sacrifice made by Barbossa, while the entire crew bids a farewell in honor of his heroism. Jack notices Karina's sad expression and passes her book to Henry in order to relieve her spirits. Henry approaches Karina and asks if she is all right, but her response was negative, as she mentions she found her father, but has lost him again. Henry then gives her back the book, saying it's all right while calling her Miss Smith, but she smiles and responds that her name is Barbossa. Afterward, Henry and Karina are dropped off, not far away from Henry's home, then the two share a romantic moment with each other, as Henry leans in to kiss her, but earns a slap. After that, Henry sees the Flying Dutchman and his freed father William Turner walking toward him. He approaches Henry and sees his necklace, knowing it belongs to his son. William embraces Henry, who promises to tell him the story of how he freed him. They are soon joined by Elizabeth, who runs up to see her husband. Meanwhile on the Black Pearl, while looking through his spyglass, Jack witnesses Elizabeth and Will's reunion, as well as the new union of Henry and Karina, calling their happiness a truly revolting sight. Joshua Mee Gibbs and the crew welcome Jack back as their captain, as Jack the Monkey makes amends with Sparrow by returning his beloved compass. After the credits, William is sleeping in bed with Elizabeth. But suddenly the door opens, and a shadowy figure slowly walks in. We then see the claw of Davy Jones. William wakes up startled, thinking it was a nightmare. He then holds Elizabeth close, unaware that there is a trace of Jones' wet barnacles on the floor beneath them.